thank you again for being here and supporting the Republican Party. Governor Branstad sends his regrets. He was unable to be with us today. He would have loved to be here, but I want you to know that it truly is an honor for me to be here and address you this morning on behalf of our administration and what we believe is the cusp of a very pivotal legislative session. Congratulations to Speaker Polson, House Majority Leader Upmeyer. Congratulations to the Senate Republican Leader, Paul McKinley, and Senator Kettering, and Chairman Strawn on his re-election as party chair. I have great confidence in the strong leadership in the Iowa House and Senate, and I'm inspired by the talented new faces that won their election by campaigning as an unapologetic conservative. And I am privileged to be part of an administration led by a proven leader who will know how to lead on day one as governor of this great state. Congratulations on your efforts as you stood together for conservative principles as the past 2 years as both a House and Senate caucus. It was those unanimous no votes on the budget and intrusive government that allowed us to demonstrate to a very skeptical electorate that we were true to our word and it would not be business as usual. Because of your resolve, your teamwork, your consistent message of jobs, the economy, and a smaller, more transparent government, we achieved a resounding victory this past fall, sending a loud and clear message by Iowans for government to back off. You know, often after a landmark election, you hear people speak of political capital and how it must be spent wisely and with caution. I would suggest that now is the time to spend it boldly. That if we unite behind a firm commitment to serve all Iowans based on the sound conservative principles that we campaigned on, I believe that the capital earned in 2010 will not be spent, but rather invested with future dividends produced. We face many challenges ahead, but within great challenges lie great opportunities. You can expect our administration to be a partner in our efforts to assist in creating 200,000 new jobs, raising family incomes by 25%, reducing government by at least 15%, and again, to have the nation's best schools. You can expect our administration to have an open-door policy with all of you and Iowans as we strive for more openness, more input, and cooperation throughout state government. We will again hold weekly press conferences. We will hold weekly leadership meetings and biannual leadership meetings with both parties. We will hold monthly meetings with the directors of the various departments collaborating on how we move the state forward. And we will continue to travel the state of Iowa and hold town halls gathering input from Iowans across the state. You can expect a dynamic team. Just as Governor Branstad has always done before, the Branstad-Reynolds administration has surrounded themselves with the most competent, qualified, capable individuals who all understand that they are working for the people of Iowa and not the other way around. The leaders and the team are in place. It's time to act and fulfill our obligations to the families and the taxpayers of Iowa. It's been 12 long years since a Republican has held the office of governor, and I can guarantee you that with Republicans running things in Des Moines, it means that the taxpayers will be the engine and the driver, not government. In less than a few short hours, now, the 2011 General Assembly will convene. We know the issues, we know the arguments, and we know that we must seek bold, new initiatives and truly challenge the bureaucracy as we know it. Today, as so many of you take the oath, you'll be reminded of how solemn your responsibilities are. I hope you'll take the opportunity to remind Iowans that they, we the people, are again being heard by Iowa's government. It will require strong, experienced leaders in a legislature supported by newcomers with fresh vision. It will require an experienced hand at the helm and a dedicated team. We have those pieces in place. The time for action in Iowa is now. I'm ready for a bold change and inspired leadership. How about you? I can tell you that the Branstad Reynolds administration is ready and excited to reshape Iowa's future. So let's do the right thing and get it done. God bless America, God bless Iowa, and thank you very much.